All right, so basically I'm going to make the argument that we can create life without life, i.e. we can create life using one thing, which is DNA. All right, so basically the more we learn about biology, the more we realize that it's all about organization. If you look at a cell, basically it's an example of organization, right? Without the cell wall, all these things would be floating around, and then they won't function together the way they should. And so the idea of biology is that the sum is greater than the parts. There's a whole area of research called DNA nanotech that basically does this. It organizes things. So there's examples where it creates things in three dimension and things in two dimension and things in one dimension. And one of the things that I did along with Camille, who has a poster tomorrow in the afternoon, is create one and two dimensional sheets inside cells and organize things on them. So we can also build things. So using DNA nanotech, we can also build cages. So we can create cell walls out of DNA if we wanted to. And there's a guy at Duke University who is trying to understand what creates life. So what are the fundamental principles of life? And so you might make the argument replication and transcription are, and so what are these broken down to? Well, they're broken down to things like restriction, replication, polymerization, and the idea is if you can replicate those fundamental things using DNA, then you can build entire cells out of DNA. So not just the scaffold from the outside, but also from the inside, you can have them multiply out of DNA. And the other thing you can also do is you can link these cells together using DNA. So life, as we know, isn't always a unicellular organism, right? It sometimes it's made up of more than one cell. And the idea is that you can link those cells together using things like DNA. So the idea is that you can build things out of DNA that kind of replicate the fundamentals of biology and have them replicate themselves to create creatures and maybe like other things that are alive that are entirely out of DNA. That's kind of like the argument that I'm going to try and make. Yeah, thank you.